Hello, this is Jonathan from MELBOURNE Aquaponics. In this video, we will see what kind of maintenance is required in aquaponics. I make this video to respond to one of the questions that I received on my comments. And the question was, what kind of maintenance is required in aquaponics? So I think maintenance can be classified in different categories, right? You got some things that you have to do every day, but they are not really maintenance, such as feeding the fish. I wouldn't classify it as maintenance. I think it's part of the hobby. But anyway, it's better to do it every day, right? I made a special video on it, and I recommend actually to feed your fish 3 times a day if you can, because it's gonna improve the growth. But once a day is completely fine. If you do it once a week, obviously they're gonna survive, but you're gonna decrease the growth of the fish. So that's I would say that's the first thing to do in an aquaponic setup every day is to feed your fish and to take care of them. The second point that I wouldn't classify in the maintenance, but it's still something you have to do frequently, is obviously to harvest your vegetables, because your vegetables are going to grow obviously every day. And depending on what you want to grow, you may have to, for example, me in my little setups, every morning I do some juice, and I drink the juice of my spinach and my beetroots. So that's something that I do every day. Now, if you grow some other vegetables, you may have to harvest them only once a week. I mean, that's completely up to you. When I talk about harvest, I also talk about removing the dead leaves and those kind of things. You can leave them into the system. It's going to design a very complex ecosystem as well. But as far as I'm concerned, I like to have the system a bit clean, not completely clean, right? It's not a problem if there are some dead leaves on the top of the media. But you know, there is a minimum like that I like to have. I don't like when it's really when it looks really untidy. Then a real maintenance is the water testing. The water test, a lot of people recommend to do them once a week. In this case, you got a really good picture of the parameters of your setup. Now, if you had the setup for a while and if you don't have many fish, you may not have to do the analysis once a week. You can maybe push them to once every 2 weeks or once a month. Some people never really test their water and they are going completely fine. But obviously, if you test your water, and you got a big biomass and you are close to the limit of the system, you're going to be able to see, to detect the problem before having a negative impact on the fish. So that's why it's always better to test the water, but you know, the frequency is really up to you, right? If you are in low density, you can really push it and do it not frequently at all. But anyway, the requirement that we give for beginners is to do it once a week. Then they got a really good understanding of how the aquaponics setup and what kind of problems they can have. Adding minerals and iron into the water, it's something that we recommend. And I remind you that we made a special video to show you how to keep your vegetables strong, green, and healthy. Obviously, that's into this video that we give all the detail of this very, very important point to avoid any deficiencies and any yellow leaves on your vegetables. So again, if you want to see this video, please see the little card on this video. But for the addition of those minerals and this iron, it can be recommended to do it every 3 weeks. So if you do the minerals and the iron in separate times, you're going to be doing you're going to add some powders into your system every 1.5 weeks. Now, it really depends on the kind of veggies you have, right? Some veggies, they don't really require this kind of addition. So yeah, really, it depends. You know, you can not have to add all those minerals and those powders in your system. It really depends of the quantity of vegetables you have and of the biodiversity and the species of vegetables you have into your setup. So again, it's very hard to give a good frequency of maintenance for this specific task. But I would say, yeah, every 3 weeks is probably a good thing, or 1.5 if you do minerals and iron. And you can push it very far. Some people never add anything and the setup is still going well. So again, it depends on the fish food you use and a lot of things, but please see the video and download the free bonus video and you're gonna have all the details. Okay, so a very important one is the cleaning of the pump. So I made a video about the bell siphon, right? And on this video, I really explain you how important it is to have a bell siphon adapted to the pump, right? Because the water flow coming into the grow bed needs to be evacuated, and the dimension of the siphon is going to be adapted to the water flow coming into the grow bed. Now, if your water pump is dirty, the water flow is going to decrease, right? So when I talk about the water pump, I'm talking about the inside of the water pump. Sometimes you got some leaves or whatever, some dust that is clogged into the pump. And so it decreases completely the water flow of the pump. Also, sometimes you got some bacteria that are inside the pipe, right? And they completely also decrease the water flow of the pipe. And so those two things combine, if they decrease the water flow of the pump, the consequences can be that your siphon doesn't work anymore. So then you are working on a constant flow level. And if you are a constant level into your grow bed, you may have some problems of oxygen, of some deficiencies of oxygen into your grow bed. And in this case, your bacteria are gonna slowly die, or you know, you can have some fermentation in some parts of the system. So it's not going to be good for, obviously, the bacteria. For the vegetables, it's not going to be good neither, because the roots need to be in an aerobic environment. But for the fish, is going to be dramatic, because this can have a very bad impact on the water quality, and especially on the ammonia and nitrate quantity into the water. So if it's just for a week, it's completely fine, right? It's not going to have an impact, because you know, you still have a lot of oxygen into your water, you know, with all those flush. So even if the water level into the grow bed is blocked constant for a while, it's okay. But if it's remaining for months, then it can be a real problem. So yeah, you need to make sure that your siphon is working and the water flow of the pump is constant. So really, cleaning the pump is the base of aquaponics. You should keep an eye on the water flow at least once a week. You look if the water flow still remains the same, and make sure that your bell siphon is working, it's stopping and it's starting every 30 minutes or whatever it is. So the frequency of the cleaning of the pump is going to be dependent of the months of the year you are in. So basically, the frequency of cleaning of the pump is going to be dependent of the temperature, right? So if the temperature is very high, you're going to have a lot of growth of bacteria inside the pipe, and you will need to grow to clean the pipe quite often. If it's in winter, for example, you are not going to have this problem, but you still have the problem if you have some leaves or fins into your grow bed that go into the pump and then that stuck the pump. So it really depends how clean is your system, how much you feed your fish, all those kind of things, right? So it can go from cleaning the pump once every 2 months to once every week, really. You know, it's really variable, and it really, again, it depends of the use you have of your aquaponics. Another one is cleaning the bottom of the fish tank. So this is not something very frequent to do. Some people never really do it, but obviously if you overfeed your fish, or if you have a lot of biomass and you got a bit of sedimentation on the bottom of the fish tank, you will need to clean it sometimes, sometimes. Again, I made a video about how to keep your fish tank clean. It's very easy with a siphon, it takes 5 to 10 minutes. And you can maybe do it if you overfeed your fish sometimes, if you see that there is some food left on the bottom, or if for any reason there is some dirt or some mud on the bottom of the fish tank. So it's really something that you may have to do never, or every 6 months, or every month, depending of how you feed your fish. So the last thing that I'm gonna talk about in this video in terms of maintenance is the growbed maintenance. So all those things that I talked about until now were little things that you need to do once a while, but don't take really any real time. You know, it takes 5 minutes here and there, or harvesting your veggies can take a bit more time, but it's still a pleasure because this is the purpose of aquaponics, is to produce some vegetables, right? Now, the thing I'm going to talk about now is a bit more complex, a bit more hard work, but it's really rare that you have to do it, right? It's cleaning the grow bed. So the grow bed is going to be, with the time, is going to be full, you know, with all the roots of your vegetables and all those kind of things. When the vegetables when you harvest the vegetables, you remove the roots. Sometimes obviously you still have some roots that remain into the grow bed. You get a lot of organic matter that are here from different sources, from the leaves, from the animals that live into the grow bed. You know, those worms, they try to dig to eat these organic matters, but they produce other kinds of organic matters, and it's a very complex ecosystem. But still, you still have an accumulation of the organic matters, and that's why actually an old system works much better than a young system, because an old system has got a very, very complex ecosystem, and you got all these different organic matters in different stages, and they're going to be degraded in different elements. Obviously, you still have the nitrogen cycle, but you got all those little minerals around that are going to be released into the system at different stages. And so an old system is going to be very rich in organic matters, and so it's going to be full of basically fertilizer for your plants. That's why then you can grow tomatoes and those kind of quite high-consuming nitrogen plants. So you have an accumulation of these organic matters between your media, and this organic matter, with the time, you know, you got all those bacteria around that are going to eat them as well. But then the bacteria are going to die, and everything. It's a full cycle, right? But the organic matters are going to grow and accumulate a bit into the media, and after maybe 2 years or 4 years, 6 years, whatever, depending on how you use the system and what kind of temperature you have around, you will have the system that is going to start to clog. Even if you got a bell siphon that is doing a very good job, the water circulation into the grow bed is going to decrease, and you're going to have some areas that may turn anaerobic, which is a problem. Every few years you will need to clean your grow bed. So when I say clean your grow bed, it's simply having the input of water and sending the output from the bell siphon into a normal garden, and you move your grow bed, you move all the media, right? You move it, you do a mechanic action on the media to release all the little organic matters that are clogged between the media. Right, and by doing so, the water is going to turn completely black, and you're going to send this water into your normal garden, and then obviously the quantity of organic matter that you're going to have into your grow bed are going to decrease, and you can go again for a few more years, and every few years then you need to do this action again. So that's quite a heavy job to do, right? It takes maybe an hour per grow bed, or maybe less, depending on the equipment you use. Some people use a water pipe, some people use water pipe plus air, and they blow some air into the system, so it really makes a big move. I mean, there are different ways to clean your media, but anyway, that's a job you need to do once every 2 or 3 years. So that's really the biggest job you have to do in aquaponics in terms of maintenance. The rest is really some little things here and there. So I hope this video helped you to understand what having an aquaponic setup at home requires in terms of maintenance. Again, I think it's quite reasonable. You don't have to do much apart from obviously feeding your fish and harvesting your vegetables. If you like the video, please share it and like it. And don't forget to get the bonus video to see how to keep your vegetables strong, green and healthy. It's going to explain you really how to add minerals into your grow bed to maintain your vegetables in good health. So now I just made a really big cleanup on my grow bed here, because I had all those tomatoes, right? And as I told you in one of my last videos, when I got a lot of one crop, I know that I'm going to have some troubles with some pests. And here I was sure I would have some troubles with caterpillars, and I had a lot of trouble. So today I cleaned a lot of dead leaves, you know, old fins, because this is the end of the season. Actually, I'm going to show you how many. You see, that's a quantity of leaves that we removed from the system. But if we have a look now very closely, you can see that I spot a lot of caterpillars, and obviously all those caterpillars I use them for my fish, because I think this is a super good source of proteins. I really love it. That's free and that's sustainable. But I spot some that were going to transform into a butterfly. I think that's quite interesting, so I'm going to try to show you that. There is one on the aquaponics bench, because I left the bench lifted, so obviously they went into the space between the wood. They thought it was a good place to hide. Unfortunately, when I opened the bench, we can really see the caterpillars. And two others here as well. They're transforming. And again, another one just here. But I also found some other animals much more interesting, I think. It's really pretty, isn't it? So this one is doing a crazy good job in the aquaponics, obviously. It's eating a lot of insects around. You can see that the leaves of this specific rhubarb has got holes, because there is a caterpillar on it. But I'm sure this my little friend here is going to take care of the problem. So again, when I say let's have a big biodiversity, you see the reason why, right? You've got so many insects and they regulate each other. So it always takes a bit of time, but this is a question of balance, right? When you got a good balance into the aquaponics, it really helps.